Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to St. Joseph's Church, and we're all so glad that you can be here to worship with us today. Is there anyone celebrating a birthday, an anniversary, or any other special occasion this week? Over here, who do we have?
26 years in marriage.
Holy cow. Assist with the cleanup of our church grounds on Saturday, May 14th. Please see the details in this weekend's bulletin and sign up in Holy Family Hall. Let us show our neighbors how important it is to work together to clean up and beautify our church property, and refreshments will be provided. Every Sunday, Jesus draws us here as a shepherd draws his flock. My sheep hear my voice, he says in today's gospel, and they follow me. Jesus is the good shepherd. He feeds his flock with his own body and blood. He loves his flock, suffering and dying for us. He provides for his flock by sending us the Holy Spirit. At home, in the comforting embrace of our good shepherd, we join together today in thanks and praise. Today's Mass is offered for the repose of the souls of Millie Benny, Susan Rice, Rose Newcomb, and Rosa Gloria. We also pray for Thomas F. Neelan, who passed away this week and whose funeral is tomorrow. Our celebrant today is Father Leo Market, assisted by Deacon Stephen Lake.
Rise from your sleeping and Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And be with your spirit.
And may gather with God's Easter people, and also on this Mother's Day, may we call to mind our sins and ask God for forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you came to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are sent to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
On the Sabbath day, they went into the synagogue and sat down. When the meeting of the synagogue broke up, many Jews and devout converts to Judaism followed Paul and Barnabas to continue in the grace of God. The next Sabbath, almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord. But when the Jewish officials saw the crowds, they were filled with jealousy. And blaspheming, they contradicted what was spoken by Paul. Then both Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly, saying, "It is necessary that the word of God should be spoken first to you. Since you reject it and judge yourselves to be unworthy of eternal life, we are now turning to the Gentiles. For so the Lord has commanded us, saying, 'I have set you to be a light for the Gentiles, so that you may bring salvation to the ends of the earth. When the Gentiles heard this, they were glad and praised the word of the Lord. As many as had been destined for eternal life became believers. Thus, the word of the Lord spread throughout the region. But the officials incited the devout women of high standing and the leading men of the city and stirred up persecution against Paul and Barnabas and drove them out of their region. So they shook the dust off their feet in protest against them and went on to Iconium. And the disciples were filled with joy and with the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. No one can take them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all. And no one can take them out of my Father's hand. The Father and I are one." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This past week, I had the privilege of being down in Lancaster County in Pennsylvania with another priest. And we were privileged to go to the Sight and Sound Theater. Anybody been there? So, they put on the beautiful show of David. And in that show, David, as you know, wrote the beautiful Psalms. They were all songs originally written by him. And Psalm 23 he did on stage. "The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want." And so today, very appropriately, we celebrate the Good Shepherd Sunday, in which we hear Jesus talking about himself as the Good Shepherd. We here live in a city, and we don't have a lot of sheep running around. They had 33 of them on the stage the other day. And sheep were very, very important in Israel then, as well as today, for meat, for wool, and also for the sacrifices offered at the temple in Jerusalem. Sheep are very, very mild meat animals. And they follow and taught to follow only the voice of their shepherd, Christ. In his life here on earth, compared himself to a shepherd. And we just sang together in the responsorial psalm, "We are his people, the sheep of his flock." So we must ask ourselves today, how well do we listen to the promptings of God in our lives? And then, how well do we carry out what Jesus is saying to us? We see him today as our shepherd. The word shepherd in Latin is pastor. We're blessed with a new pastor here at St. Joseph's, Immaculate Conception, and a Lady of Grace, Father Tom. And he is our local shepherd. Our bishop is our diocesan shepherd. Our Holy Father, Pope Francis, is our church, the entire church, representing Christ as our leader and our shepherd. And certainly Jesus continues to lead you and me. And hopefully we will follow him as sheep follow the voice of their shepherd, and only their shepherd, no one else. We are a blessed people. We're here today on this gorgeous day to celebrate Good Shepherd Sunday. Sacraments are so important in our lives. We have a young baby over here that will be baptized after Mass. We have two beautiful children here, Kennedy and Leah, who will make their first communion. And that's so beautiful. It reminds us of our own first communion, a few or many years ago. You know when I made my first communion? You want to know? 1943. And we were prepared, not by Christine and other teachers here, we were prepared by the Franciscan nuns. They didn't use I said, oh, these taste good. So we had neck of wafers in preparation for our first communion. Today, Kennedy and Leah, we honor you, and we thank God for the gift of you to your parents. And also, as we celebrate Mother's Day, honoring our Blessed Mother and our mothers here on earth. My mom died in 1984, but I pray for her and pray to her. And so pray today for your mothers. If they're living, pray and thank them for giving you life. If they're in heaven, continue to ask them for their intercession and pray to them. And today, as we gather here with these two beautiful little girls, baby to be baptized, we see that life is what we're all about. God didn't have to create us, but he did. And he created us in his own image and likeness. Each of us is a child of God. Each of us is made in the image and likeness of God, and we are treasured. We are priceless. And if we were the only person in the world, Jesus would have died on that cross just for us. That's how important each one of you is. Each of you is so important in God's sight. He loves us unconditionally. And so we gather today on First Communion Day, on Mother's Day, to honor both mothers. Motherhood is a beautiful vocation in which you as women cooperate with God in bringing new life into the world. Husband and wife in the sacrament of marriage, how beautiful. Tomorrow I'll have a class with my seniors at Notre Dame Bishop Gibbons. And it's the marriage class. You know what I tell them? You want to have a good marriage? Be a winner and pick a winner. I think that's good theology. And then on Friday, the seniors will have a demonstration marriage. We'll have a bride and groom, best man, maid of honor. We do all the readings, the exchange of rings, and it's an opportunity for the kids to see what Christian marriage is all about. Love. The opportunity for Christ to reach out and bless marriages, your marriages. Motherhood, so important. I was a young priest in Oneonta in 1962, my first parish. And I went up to Fox Hospital in Oneonta. And I stopped and looked at all the newborn babies in the maternity ward. And there was a mother there, looking in through the glass at her child. I didn't meet her yet, but I said, is this your first child? She said, no, this is my third. But I so beautifully thank God for the miracle of birth and of children. It turns out she was my next door neighbor near the rectory. Her name was Maggie, and she ended up having four children. We honor you today as mothers. We thank God for the gift of your example, your teaching, and your prayers for all of us. So may God bless us today, each day of our lives, as we honor him today as our good shepherd, as we honor our blessed mother, Jesus' mom, whom he gave to us from the cross. We honor Mary, and all others, both living and dead. And we honor Kennedy and Leah as they come up to make their first communion. May we remind all of us of our first communion and realize that Jesus is going to take this bread that you bring down. And it is he that will change that plain bread, not necco wafers, but bread, into his own body and blood, soul and divinity. And as I give that host to Kennedy and Liam and say the body of Christ, and they say, Amen. That Amen means yes. Yes, I believe this is Jesus, truly, body and blood, soul and divinity. So may their first communion remind us of our first communion and all the communions that we have received in our lifetime. And may we never, ever take it for granted. God bless all of you on your journey through life, and know how much God loves you, and I love you also. Of our beautiful Catholic faith.
I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us now pray. Jesus, assure us that we will always be safe the Father's hands, and so we have the confidence to turn to God with our needs and the needs of the whole world.
Our response this morning is, Risen Savior, hear our prayer. For the Church, that we may be a light in the darkness and an instrument of salvation to the ends of the earth, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For those in positions of authority, that the Good Shepherd may be their model in the way they protect and guide those in their care, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For an end to the suffering and death in Ukraine, so that life be restored and that goodness flourish once more, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For parents, teachers, and all who first show children how to love as Jesus did, and for all of our children who make First Eucharist this weekend, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For mothers, grandmothers, godmothers, and all those who model the role of mother in our lives, that they may be blessed.
Risen, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For those who are discerning a vocation, that they follow the Good Shepherd who leads them, and for all those who have yet to respond, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, isolated, depressed, or addicted, as well as for all our medical and military personnel and first responders, to feel the presence of the merciful Shepherd who brings them comfort and hope. We pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For our beloved deceased, that they may be embraced in God's heart for eternity, especially Millie Bennett, Susan Rice, Rose Newcomb, and Rosa Gloria, who we remember in this Eucharist. We pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For our silent prayers and intentions. We pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
Loving God, you show us your love through the Good Shepherd, who died on the cross to give us life in abundance. Hear the prayers we bring in his name, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but especially in this time when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Bishop Edmund and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her husband, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go now and announce the gospel of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.